Joy to the world, the Lord is come.
Here was a man who was born in an obscure village, the child of a simple peasant woman. He grew up in another obscure village. Until he was 30 years of age, he worked as a carpenter. And then for 3 years, he was a traveling preacher. He never wrote a book. He never held political office. He never owned a home. He never had a family. He never went to college. He never set foot inside a big city. He never traveled more than 200 miles from the place of his birth. And where he did go, he usually walked. He never did one of the things that one usually associates with greatness. He had no credentials but himself. He had nothing to do with this world except through the supreme power of his divine manhood. While still a young man, the tide of popular opinion turned against him. Most of his friends ran away. One of them denied him. One of them even betrayed him and turned him over to his enemies. He went through the mockery of a trial and was nailed to a wooden cross between two thieves. And even while he was dying, his executioners gambled for the only piece of property he had in this world, and that was his robe, his purple robe. When he was dead, he was taken down from the cross and laid in a borrowed grave provided by compassionate friends. Nineteen wide centuries have since come and gone, and today he is the centerpiece of the human race, the leader in the column of human progress. I think I am well within the mark when I say that all of the armies that ever marched, all of the navies that ever sailed the seven seas, all of the legislative bodies that ever sat, and all of the kings that ever reigned, all put together, have not affected the life of man on this earth so powerfully as that one solitary life. Here was a man.
Go!